Welcome to my channel. And today I wanted to provide to you a holiday gift guide for babies 0 to 12 months old. My daughter Nori will be 11 and a half months old at Christmas time, which means this will be her very, very first Christmas ever and my first Christmas as a mom. So I'm super duper excited. And it doesn't matter what holiday you celebrate, you could celebrate Kwanzaa or Hanukkah. If it's something that's big in your house that you look forward to year round, like I look forward to Christmas, you're going to want to make it memorable for your little one. Even if they won't really, really remember it, you'll have lots of video and pictures. So you want it to be somewhat enjoyable so that when they look back on it, they can reminisce on how cute they were opening their gift for the first time or you helping them open their gift. And I wanted to provide gifts for the babies the first year of life, because it can be a little bit more difficult to try to figure out what to give them, especially if they're only like 3 weeks old. They could be like a day old, you know. So I just wanted to help you out this holiday season, whether you're buying for your own kids or if you're buying for your grandkids or your nieces and nephews or your best friend's kids or just kids in general, you know, if you're giving to a local homeless shelter or women's shelter, or we have the St. Louis Crisis Nursery, you want to be able to provide gifts that they could use and need. So I'm going to try to stay in like age order the best that I can. So first I'm going to kind of focus on that 0 to 3 months age. Now, starting off the bat, if you are buying a Christmas gift for somebody else, something that could be really, really useful is diapers. I know that sounds kind of weird, and you could get a little toy to go with it, but I know like diapers are so expensive, and if they cloth diaper, maybe ask them, you know, is there any cloth diapering tools or anything that you need? Now first, what you really, really, really want for a baby, which I think are definitely teething toys. Now these are awesome. It's that 0 to 3 month stage. They may not really be teething and it may not be something super duper interesting for them, which this could really go from the 3 to 6 month. And actually Nori doesn't even have her teeth yet and she's definitely like gnawing on everything. So teething toys are great for the entire year because they're always chewing on something. And then when you get to about that 9 month, 8 month stage, or when they're starting to eat solids, they definitely are interested in putting things in their mouth. So you want to encourage them to put things in their mouth that are supposed to be there, like teething toys, puffs, you know, anything that's age appropriate. And I would check, because some teething toys are not for the 0 to 3 month age. This definitely is. I just got this on clearance at Target. I got it before Nori was born. My mom bought this, like this is 0 to 3 month, just got it at Walmart. My friend got these wooden ones. I would say these are probably for a little bit older babies. They may be listed as, you know, younger, but Nori did knock herself kind of in the mouth with it, and it is wood. So it did hurt her a little bit. She was fine, it was just that initial like, whoa. But now she's a little bit older and can handle it better. Her fine motor skills are more, you know, exact, so she's not really knocking things into her face when she's trying to put it in her mouth. But teething toys, for sure. Another thing that I think is really good for that 0 to 3 month age is a lovey, because when it comes to, I don't know what else you call this, but basically it looks like just like a little stuffed animal and it has like a little blanket attached. Nori has like 3 of these, and actually her like lovey is a sheep, which I didn't want to grab that from her because right now she's being occupied by preoccupied by her dad so she can play. So I didn't want to take her beloved toy. But these are definitely comfort items. This is why it's really important to have this, because when it's time to sleep train and you're making routines for them, you want them to have something that's familiar for them. Kind of going along with that, stuffed animals are always really nice. This is another one that's good year-round, the entire year. So Nori loves to practice giving kisses to her stuffed animals, but it is a fun, nice little tool that they can play with when they're younger. Just kind of feeling you can teach them like different textures of how different things feel by taking their little hands and feeling it. Now they won't have the skills to grasp or grab at it or anything, but you know, it doesn't hurt. And Nori loved this thing when she was 3 months old because you press the belly and it plays a little music. The batteries are actually running low because we pressed it all the time. Another thing, if you can't hear it, is the rattle. This is a little one that I got from Target. It looks like a stuffed animal, but it's a rattle. You can get a hard rattle or anything. It's good for their hands. I know when Nori was younger, they have wrist rattles, which I also bought at Target. And you put it around their wrist and it has a rattle attached, so they're shaking their hands and it rattles. So that's something that's really, really fun for them too. This next thing's kind of big, so I'm gonna try my best to keep it in the shot. But it's one of these like little activity mats or whatever. It has little things hanging down and you can press. I think I have it turned off right now, yeah. And you can press it and it plays different music, has different stuff. So you can have them play the piano. Or Nori's favorite setting is leaving it on the lullaby, and she likes the lullabies. What's really good about this is you can use this right away. So you have the mirror here, so you can practice baby in the mirror. You have little hanging things that will encourage them to reach up and bat at stuff, which is a skill they will be working on, as different noises and textures. I know Nori's favorite was this little lion rattle, and the day she could reach it, I mean, it was the best day ever. And what also is helpful about it is that it encourages tummy time. So you want to practice tummy time, whether you first put them on there or when it's time to start rolling over around that 3-4 month mark and you lay them on their back and they start to roll over onto their tummy and do tummy time themselves. But when you put them on their tummy initially, when they're a little bit younger, which you want to practice tummy time, I think from when they're like a month old. I don't, you have to double check. I'm not an expert, I'm just a mom. So, which is the problem. A lot of people take these things as people being experts, but at the end of the day, we are just moms, unless, you know, you're like a pediatrician mom or something like that. But when it's the piano and we have the lullaby going, she's doing her tummy time and she's focusing on the lights that are turning on, the sound that's coming out of it. So it helps her keep her head up and really work those neck muscles. So that's the 0 to 3 month, which can also be used at all for any of the other ages. So I'm gonna kinda look a little bit, this is going to be a big gap, but from the 3 to 9 month, only because they are rapidly learning between that time. I mean, they go from just being able to like do tummy time successfully and rolling over to army crawling, then regular crawling, then pulling themselves up, and then cruising around furniture. I mean, it happens so quickly, and really, if your baby is, I would say, about a couple weeks shy from the next month, so if they're like 3 months old and they have like 2 weeks until they're 4 months, I would aim for the older age of that stuff. Sorry, my air kicked on. There's nothing I can do about that. But anyway, so ignore that sound. So one thing that I think is very useful for that big gap here is this fun little activity table. Oops, getting caught on my tree. So you can take the legs off here. I'm not going to because we don't really use it. You can take the legs off and they can just use this. It turns on. And they can flip things when they're starting to work on that fine motor. They can grab this and move it here. And then they can press. Nori pulls herself up on this and loves it. So that's another thing she can use when they're older. Here's sounds, encourages them to touch things. But when they're younger, I'd use it without the legs first. And then you can use it when they are older. I'm not quite sure what the age is listed on that, but I'd say we probably busted it out around 5 months to 6 months of age, and especially when they can sit up on their own too. This one is 6 months plus, and this is going to be one of Nori's Christmas gifts. I accidentally bought two, so this one's getting donated. But it is those blocks, and it helps her do critical thinking skills by trying to match shapes. Of course, she's not going to be like getting that right off the bat, but it helps, and you can use it for stacking purposes. This is really, really cheap. You could buy it at Walmart or whatever, but I think I got it cheaper on Amazon. I double check. I always double check if anything's cheaper on Amazon. So this was marketed for a younger age to 3 months plus. So this is another thing. It lights up. It makes noise at different settings. And you press the buttons and it makes music and helps them press things. And it's also good for when they're practicing to sit up on their own, because then they can sit and press the stuff themselves. Nori loves chewing up here, so it's good for that, I guess, too. I don't know if that was its intention, but it works. And when they get a little bit older, they can handle the toys that are a little bit harder. This is like run mostly out of batteries. You can't even hear it anymore. But it's a little cell phone. I like to practice communication skills with Nori. So I hold it up and I'll say, hi, hi, and then put it to her ear to try to encourage her to speak and say hi, which I think this is the reason why she knows how to say hi, because we practice talking on the phone. And then you have a little bit harder rattles, and these are good too for when they're older. They can flip, they have the sounds, they have these little ends here designed to be chewed on, different textures, so you can talk about that. When they're older, you can count with them so they can learn talk counting. Good gift at any age, so this isn't just specific to this age group, but any age, are books. I got a couple books here. Nori has like a massive bookshelf full of books, and it also helps them learn communication because they are learning how to say things. It's very important to talk to your baby and talk to them often because you are going to be their source for how to talk and things like that. So from the 9 to 12 month, you want to get things that are a little bit bigger and a little bit more complex, because some of the toys I previously showed you, Nori has like zero interest in already, and what she wants is something different. So I got this here. I forgot how it's called, like a biscuit, or I don't even know, but it's the original calculator, and I got this for $10 at IKEA. You can pretty sure find this anywhere. I already looked it up online. You can find it on Amazon. So she can stand with it. She can work on her skills at grabbing it and hearing the sounds by rubbing her hands and feeling how that is. Kind of that cause and effect too of, okay, if I hit two of these together, it makes a sound, because they're learning that cause and effect. Keep using this too to teach them colors, because there's different colors. And for counting, I did say it's the original calculator. My husband tried explaining to me how like this is like 1,000 or something stupid like that. I don't know. Not stupid, sorry. But you could count it one by one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on and so forth. How this is used to multiply, I don't know. He tried telling me, but I'm not a math person. So we count with our fingers around these parts of town. Another classic toy to have is a xylophone. Now, you have to be very careful when you are introducing this toy, because especially for Nori, she loves sticking these bad boys up in her mouth, and she just hangs it in there and she moves around. So if she were to bump anything, it'd go boop. So just keep an eye on your baby. It did market this for her age, so it's not like it's out of age range for her, but with anything, just watch them. And you can teach them music, that cause and effect, so if I hit this, it makes this noise. She loves banging really these on the table instead of this. She likes hitting her hand on this, but it still makes noise, so she still likes it. If you need stocking stuffer ideas, just find little things in smaller sizes and stick them in there. And I'm not saying you have to buy 20,000 toys for your kids to have a great Christmas. You don't. And then I know I mentioned at the beginning that I was going to talk about a way to save money, because they won't really, really remember. I knew this woman who would buy her kids toys at garage sales, and you could clean it up, or if you buy it where it looks pretty good, in pretty good shape, they're never going to know it's not brand new. And also, your kid doesn't have to have everything that is brand new. We have used different things that we borrowed from people, like the little bouncers where you sit in them. We borrowed that from our friends. Thanks, Mandy and Corey. Because they said, well, they only use this for a couple months. You want to save your money. Like, you don't have to buy every single item that your kid needs. If it's something that you think they will use for a long time, or you see a lot of benefit out of it, then definitely buy that. But there's certain things that you don't have to buy brand new. So save your money. They're not going to care. Well, that is all that I have for you today. If you have any of your own suggestions, leave them down in the comments below, because I would love to know what maybe you got your kids when they were this age, especially now that Nori's first birthday is like right after Christmas. I got a thing of first birthday presents too. So tell me what you have in mind, and I would love to check it out.